Mr. Ashley Paulk of the Democratic Party.
Thank you all for having me. Although I went to public university, I closed out to VSU on the Quarterman campus. Don't bring it up now. The hospital used to be down the street in 1945. So I've been here all my life. So I thought the Quarterman was a good hospital. Been very blessed with my life and very my students. We are sitting out there 49 years, I thought. Blessed with 5 children, 23 grandchildren. I have a lot of interest in this county. Of course, a lot of you realize I was a sheriff for 16 years. I chose to retire, became county commission chairman for 4 years, served there as the worst economic county. I think I'm the only person as chairman who's never built a thing. I tore down the building. So I'm very fiscally responsible. And you wonder why that is when being a sheriff. The sheriff's budget is due to make sure sitting out there. It's the largest budget in the county. The only budget that this present administration has kept in budget was the budget I did when I left. So that's one of the things the sheriff needs to do to be fiscally responsible. We had tax increases this year. And a lot of it had to do with the sheriff's department and overspending. So that's one of the things I want to build back. When I was sheriff for 16 years, we built a nationally recognized department. We did a great in drug addiction. We generated sometimes over 50% of our budget. And that's where we need to work there too. We need to have, if I can get the returns I had back then, I can get better salaries, better jobs for people, and we need to do that. Law enforcement, same thing. Law enforcement is in a terrible time, and a lot of people ask me, why in the world would you go back into it? Well, I love Lowndes County. I love that job. I love the people. You run the whole department with common sense and compassion. But I want to rebuild it. I want to make Lowndes County a safe place for us to live the rest of our life. I have a vested interest in it, of course. I have 2 sons who are here in business with me. We farm, we're contractors. You know, we just always work, always be part of the community. I've done the cancer drive for 35 years. Boys Club, Boys Ranch, you name it. If I hadn't been part of it, she has. So, you know, we work as a team. You get me, you're going to get Ginger. Just tell me that. Very important. I could not do the job without her. But things that I had to share with Paulk were gone. I was not gone. We had a work program that got an inmate a job while he was in jail. He was taking to work every morning. And employees loved him because he was sober and drug free the whole time and clean because he was lonely and he survived. So the best support to him. But you take a man that had a year in jail. And if he can judge our complaint, and he's free to help again, he's retired, but he's still a judge of merit. We set up a deal, you got a year in jail, he's for 9 miles, send a driver's license, child support. You got a year in jail, you've got a regular job, a regular place, those are in the dust department. You didn't get fired, you get fired just like a regular person. But if you survived your job and did a good job, your son got cut in half. That's 6 months off a man's son. And it takes 6 months off, $50 a day, $9 an inmate. We had 150 in that program. The first year, it saved over $1 million in incarceration. And being a sheriff is not all about just keeping people in jail. But there are a lot of good people make bad mistakes and need help. If you give them, get their head above the water. And their check actually came to the sheriff's department. So we made sure their bills were paid. We made sure the job support was paid, the fines were paid. When most of them got out, their head was above water. But the interesting thing about it, about 60 to 80% of them let their check keep coming to us and let us manage their money. And they stayed out of jail, so we got rid of the recidivism. So you've got to have these proactive programs. I can't walk and look at the county commission and say I need an extra $1 million next year. I want to look and tell them I saved you $2 million, I want about a half of that my glory. We talk to them like that, I know about the commission. So, you know, you got to give and take, you can't just take all the time. So I'm gonna rebuild those roads. You, when was the last time you saw a car wreck in Paulk City, so they're not the fault of your tax dollars. I mean, that was, you never bought cars with your money in Paulk. We even gave 20 to the city one year, I mean, so it can be done. You can rebuild that Paulk. I'd be rebuilding that little Paulk to do it. I know I can do it. There's some other roads we can bring in. And you gotta rebuild some relationships with other agencies, various agencies that are here in town that are all doing one line. A criminal does not see the city. I actually had two cars with signs in the city who were close to the city. So a lot of the programs are gone. They need to be rebuilt, brought back, other programs. And, you know, just have a park you can be proud of. And, you know, one of the biggest things I'm thinking campaigning is when you return my phone call. If you look at my literature, it has my cell phone. The same one I gave everybody else in the last 20 years. So if you look at the sheriff, he'll be responsive and will return your calls. I appreciate your help and your thoughts.